Hi guys, welcome to my channel, I'm John. Today I'm going to share with you how to create a rolling ball loop animation in Blender 3D 3.0 alpha version using geometry nodes. So before we dive into Blender, let me go through what we are going to do in this tutorial. First, we are going to create the cylinders and animate it using geometry nodes. And then we are going to add the ball and make it rolling on the cylinders. Then next, we are going to add the decorative object, lighting and material to finish the scene. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so before we start anything, let's set up the output setting and the camera first. So press numpad 1 to see the front view, and then hold Ctrl alternate numpad 0 to set current view as camera. Go to output properties, change the resolution X to 1080. We want to render a square image, and then change the frame start to 0 and the frame end to 120. And then change the frame rate to 30 frames per second. Then select the camera, go to camera properties tab and change the focal length to 170. Okay, now we can start to add the cylinder. So press shift A and add a cylinder. And then change the radius to 0.2 and the depth to 1.6. And then press numpad slash to focus the object. Then press tab to go into edit mode. Press 3 to change the selection mode to face select, or you can press here. And then select the face at the bottom, and then press shift S and select cursor to selected. Then press tab again to exit the edit mode. Go to object and set origin to 3D cursor. Then press numpad slash again to unfocus it. Then press G followed by X and move it beside. And then we can start to clone the cylinder using geometry nodes. So select the default cube, split the screen, go to geometry node editor, press new to apply geometry nodes to the cube, and then pin it. And then press shift A, go to mesh primitive and add a mesh circle, connect it to the group output. And actually we can delete the group input already, we don't need it anymore. And then press shift A again, go to point and add a point instance. Then use the eyedropper to select the cylinder. So now the instance object is cloned on every vertices of the mesh circle, and currently the mesh circle have 32 vertices. That means we have 32 cylinder cloning on the mesh circle now. But if you refer to our sample, we only need 7 cylinders. So to reduce it, we need to reduce the vertices to 7. Let's change the radius to 0.5. I want to make it closer. Then next, we can start animate it. So what I'm going to do is, I want to set up an empty cube as a controller to control the animation. The cylinder that touched by the empty cube will be bigger, and the cylinder outside of the empty cube will be smaller. So to do it, let's add an attribute randomized node. Add it before the point instance, and then change the max value to 0. Then we need to store the value of this node to a new attribute. Then we are going to execute it later. So let's create a new attribute by name it minimum size. I will explain why we are doing this later. Duplicate the attribute randomized node. Then create another new attribute by name it maximum size. Change the minimum and maximum value to 1. So we are storing the value of this node in this attribute. So let me explain a little bit about this. Later when we finish set up everything, the cylinder that touched by the empty cube will trigger the value of maximum size here. Then the cylinder that not touched by the empty cube will trigger the value for minimum size here. Okay, now we need to add an attribute mix to put both of the attributes together. Add it before the point instance. Hover the maximum size, press Ctrl C to copy it and paste at the attribute A. And same for the minimum size, Ctrl C and paste at attribute B. And then type scale in the result column. We want it to affect the scale of the cylinders. So now if we play with the factor, when we slide the factor to left, it will trigger the maximum size here. And if we push it to the right, it will trigger the minimum size here. Okay, now we can start to add our empty cube to the geometry node editor. So in the 3D viewport, press shift S and move the cursor to world origin. And then press shift A and add an empty cube. Let's name it controller. And then press numpad 7 to see the top view, and press S to resize the empty cube to cover one of the cylinder. Then press numpad 1 to see the front view, move the empty cube and make sure it touches the x-axis line at the bottom of the cylinders. Drag the controller into the geometry nodes editor. And now we need to let Blender know the position of the cylinders and the location of the controller. So let's add an attribute vector math, put it before the attribute mix, then change the operation to distance. In the attribute A column, select position because we want to get the position for each of the points on the mesh circle, which means by doing this, we are also getting the position of the cylinders because our cylinders is grown on this point. Okay, then change the attribute B to vector. Then we grab the location of the controller and connect it to the vector distance. This is to let Blender know where is the location of the controller. Okay, so now Blender already know the position of the cylinders and the location of the controller. And then we need to store the result in a new attribute. So let's name it distance. And then hover the distance, press Ctrl C to copy it, then go to attribute mix and change the factor to attribute, then paste the distance attribute in the factor column. And now let's split the screen into half. Press numpad 7 to see the top view, and we can move around the controller to see the effect. Okay, so please aware, when you move the controller, make sure the empty cube controller is always stay at the bottom. So now we can see the cylinder outside of the empty cube is smaller or disappeared, and the cylinder inside the empty cube is always the biggest one. So when the empty cube controller touch the cylinder, it is trigger the value of maximum size here, and for the cylinder outside of the controller, it trigger the minimum value here. Okay, now if we refer to our sample animation, the cylinder is actually moved up and down instead of scaling the entire cylinder smaller or bigger. So to fix this issue, let's go to the attribute randomized node for minimum size, and then change the type of data to vector, then change the x and y axis for minimum value to 1 and the z axis for maximum value to 0. I think I want to make the overall height slightly taller, so let's change both of the z axis to 0.7. Then next, we can start to animate the empty cube controller. Let's put the empty cube here. Then in the 3D viewport, press Shift A, go to empty and add a plane axis. Then rename it controller parent. And then select the controller. Then hold Shift and select the controller parent. Then press Ctrl P to parent it. Then select the plane axis. And now we can start to keyframe it. So drag the time indicator to 0. In the 3D viewport, press N to toggle the properties panel. In the Z axis rotation, right click and add a single keyframe, and then press this button to jump to the end frame 120. In the Z rotation, tap -360, right click and add a single keyframe, then go to the graph editor. Press A to select all keyframes, then go to view and select frame selected. Then right click, go to interpolation mode and select linear. Then let's try to press spacebar to check the animation. Okay, everything is fine. The looping is looking good. Then next, I want to add the ball rolling on top of the cylinders. So to do it, in the 3D viewport, press Shift A and add a UV sphere. Change the radius to 0.2. Drag the time indicator back to 0. Then grab the UV sphere and put it at the same position with the empty cube controller. Then press numpad 1 to see the front view. Press G followed by Z and move it higher. Put it on the cylinders. Then hold Shift and select the empty cube controller, and then press Ctrl P to parent it. Then we try to press spacebar to check the animation again. The animation is really weird. The ball is floating on the air instead of rolling. And the reason is because when our empty cube controller leaving the first cylinder, then immediately the first cylinder is going down and the second cylinder is not up until the top yet. So in order to fix this issue, we need to make the first cylinder to stay longer on the top, even the empty cube already leave. So let's go back to our geometry node editor. Let's add an attribute color ramp before the attribute mix. Hover and copy the distance attribute and paste it in the attribute column and result column. Then let's drag the black color to around 0.3. Let's put it 0.35. By doing this, we are actually make the cylinder to stay at the top slightly longer after the empty cube controller leave it. So now let's drag the time indicator back to 0. Then press numpad 1 to see the front view. Move the ball higher until it touches the top surface of the cylinder. And now let's try to press spacebar again to check the animation. And yeah, we fixed it. Then next, we need to spin the ball But before we spin the ball, let's add a material to the ball first. So drag the thumb indicator back to zero. Select the ball. Go to the Material Properties tab. Add a new material. Then press Tab to go into Edit Mode. Press 1 to see the front view. And then press Alternate G to turn on the X-ray mode. Then select half of the sphere. Press the plus button here to add a new material. Click New. And then change the base color to purple color. Or you can put any color you like. And then I want to change the roughness to 0.2. And then click Assign to assign the material. And then we can turn off the X-ray mode. Press Tab again to exit the edit mode. Right click and turn the shading to Shade Smooth. Then go to the Transform Properties. Right click the Y rotation column and add a single keyframe. And then press this button to jump to the endpoint. In the Rotation Y axis column, tap 360. We want the ball to rotate 360 degrees. Then right click and add a single keyframe. Then try to press Spacebar again to check the animation. I think the rotation speed is too slow. Maybe we can try to increase the rotation degree. Okay, let's press this button to jump to the end frame. Click the rotation Y axis. Let's try to put 360 times 3 maybe. Right click and replace the single keyframe. Let's try to check the animation again. It's a lot better now. But not sure if you noticed, the rotation is slowing down in the last few frames and it makes the looping very weird. So to fix this issue, let's go to the graph editor, press A to select all keyframes, go to view and frame selected, right click, interpolation mode, select linear, then play the animation again. Okay, everything looks good, go back to the first frame. Okay, next, I want to add some material to the cylinder. Let's select the cylinder and press numpad slash to focus the object. Then press numpad 1 to see the front view. Go to the material properties tab and create a new material. Then change the base color to yellow color. Or you can put any color you like. And then I want to change the roughness to 0.2. Then press tab to go into edit mode. Press Ctrl R to add a loop cut. Then turn on the X-ray mode, change the selection mode to face select, select the polygon faces on the top and we need to assign a new color onto it. Press the plus button, click new and change the base color to any color you like. And then click assign to assign the material, then turn off the X-ray mode, press tab to exit the edit mode. Then right click the cylinder and turn the shading to shade smooth. The shading looks a little bit weird. Let's go to the object data properties, go to normals and activate the auto smooth. Okay, then press the numpad slash again to unfocus the object. And now we can start to set up our camera. So now press numpad 0 to switch to camera view, then select the camera. Press G followed by G and move the camera higher. And then press shift tilt and adjust the camera angle you want. Then next, I want to add the decorative object to the scene. Okay, press Shift A and add a plane. Go into Edit Mode, press 1 to switch the selection mode to Vertex Select. Then right click, go to Merge Vertices and select at Center. Then press G followed by X and move the vertices beside. Then press Tab again to exit the Edit Mode. Go to the Modifier Properties and add a Screw Modifier. Then change the screw value to 0.6. Then press Numpad 7 to see the top view and scale it smaller. Press numpad 1 to see the front view and move it higher. Then we can apply the screw modifier now. Press tab to go into edit mode. Then select these vertices. Press E followed by G and extrude it. Select these vertices again. Press shift Ctrl B to bevel it. Change the width to 0.3 and the segment to 5. And then press tab again to exit the edit mode. Right click and convert it to curve. Then go to the data properties under the geometry section. Change the depth to 0.02. Press numpad 0 to switch back to camera view and then move it higher. Press R followed by G. Rotate it. I want to put the curved corner to fit with the sphere shape. Okay, now let's select our decorative object. Then hold Ctrl and select our controller parent. And then press Ctrl P to parent the object. Then, currently the mesh is very ugly, it's too low poly, we need to make it smooth. So to do it, go to the modifier properties and add a subdivision surface. Then next, we can start to add lighting to the scene. So let's delete the existing lighting. And then press Shift A and add an area light. Move it higher. Put 3 maybe. And then let's go to the render properties tab. Turn the render engine to cycles and the device to GPU compute. Turn on the render preview mode. Go to the light properties tab and turn the power to 100, make it brighter. Go to the world properties tab, change the world color to white. Then next, we almost finished the artwork. So now we need to add a backdrop to the scene. So let's press Shift A and add a cube. Resize the cube to 10 meter for X and Y axis and 4 meter for Z axis. Then go into the edit mode, switch the selection mode to face select, then select and delete 3 of these faces. Press tab to exit the edit mode. And then move the backdrop higher until the floor touched the cylinder. Then turn on the render preview. Go to the material properties tab, create a new material and change the base color to pink color, or you can put any color you like. Press numpad 0 to switch back to camera view. Okay, now let's try to render the image and we might need to do some color correction later. The render is a little bit too bright for me, so let's minimize it for now. Go to the compositing tab, tick the use node, and then press Shift A and add a RGB curve. Let's add an viewer node as well so that we are able to see the final outcome on the viewport. Connect the RGB curve to the viewer, go to the view tab and click fit to fit the image in the viewport. Then in the RGB curve, select this point and change it to 0.1. Then for this point, select it and change this one to 0.9, and then add another point at the center and drag it slightly lower. Then last, let's go to Output Properties tab. Then choose the file location where you want to output the animation. Let's create a new folder. And then you can select the file format you want. So I'm going to leave it for PNG file. Then go to Render and render the animation. Then we done it. So if you like my video, please subscribe and see you next week. Bye.